So come on down to your back.
Hi.
And let's just start to get ourselves comfortable there. Start to roll your shoulders under your back and start to take those feet out to the side. If you prefer to have any sort of prop underneath your knees here, like a folded towel or anything like that, you can get that. Props that we're going to use today are going to be very minimal, but if you do want to grab yourself some blocks here or hard books or any sort of extra cushioning with a towel or a blanket, by all means you can. Starting to roll those shoulders deeper now into the back. Start to check in with that jaw. Are you in any way clenching or holding there? Taking a deep breath in through the nose. Let's exhale it here twice as long through the mouth. Letting those limbs be heavy into the mat, tucking the chin ever so slightly into the chest. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And exhale twice as long through the mouth. One more time, take a deep breath in through the nose. And exhale twice as long through the mouth. And then when you are ready, start to bring that mouth to closed. Start to bring the length of the inhalation to seamlessly match the length of your exhalation, taking a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Roll those shoulders deeper into the back here. And then on the start of the next breath, clearing that busy, busy mind, focusing on that breath. Start to incorporate your ujjayi breath, breathing here from the back of the throat. Make a ha sound, or the sound of the ocean tide. Breathe in and breathe out. Using these deep, audible breath throughout your practice is going to help you better achieve your poses with fresh, warm air, warm blood to those muscles. Inhale and exhale here. And then on the start of the next breath, focusing in on an intention perhaps you'd like to set for your practice. Seeing that intention in the here and in the now, work from it, work with it, breathe in. And breathe out. And then on the start of the next breath, let's start to take those hands and start to fold them in towards your body. Start to rock those feet now to touch, and then slowly and gently start to rise the arms, sweeping them all the way up overhead. Reach towards the back of the room and then point your toes towards the front. Taking a deep breath in here, stretching in two different directions. Inhale. And on the exhalation, start to sweep those arms all the way down to the sides of your body. Start to fold the knees up in towards you and rock your knees in a little circle all the way around to the right. Waking up that lower lumbar spine, let's go the opposite direction. And then nice and slow, start to take those feet, slide them all the way back down your mat. Point your toes, inhale, rise those arms all the way up overhead. Reach two different directions here. Take a deep breath in. On the exhalation, start to slide your arms overhead over to the right. And then start to slide your feet over to the right, coming into banana pose here as we start to stretch out that whole side body here, taking a deep breath in. Exhaling, doing your best to keeping your shoulders down on the mat. Inhale. And on the exhalation, slide yourself back to center. Roll those shoulders deeper into the back, loosen through that jaw, and then nice and gentle here, start to slide your upper body the opposite direction, and start to slide your your legs over to the side as well. Coming into that half moon banana-like pose. Take a deep breath in. Roll those shoulders deeper to back, loosen through that jaw. Inhale. And on the exhalation, start to roll yourself back to center. From center, start to sweep those arms all the way down to the sides of your body here. And then slowly and gently start to slide your hands to your lower lumbar spine, taking your hands right underneath your bum here. Start to roll your shoulders deeper into your back and tuck your chin into your chest. Nice and gentle here, start to take your knees up towards your chest. And then slowly start to extend those feet all the way to the sky. Point your toes towards your face and tuck your chin into your chest. Take a deep breath in. And on the exhalation, start to slide that right foot all the way down so it is hovering right over the mat here. Flex your foot, spread your yogi toes, breathe in. And then exhale, bring that foot back up to the sky. Bending into those knees, bring them in towards your chest. And then push those feet all the way away from you. Bend those knees, bring them in towards your chest. And then push your feet all the way away from you. One more time, bend those knees in towards your chest. And then push those feet all the way away from you. Checking in that your chin is still tucked into your chest. Exhale, start to take that left foot to just over the mat. Keeping that foot flexed, take a deep breath in. And then exhale, bring those feet to meet in the sky. Inhale, pull the knees in towards your chest. Exhale, push those feet away. Inhale, pull the knees in towards your chest. Exhale, push those feet away. One more time, inhale, pull the knees in towards your chest. Exhale, push those feet away. Float that right foot to just over the mat. Roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Inhale. And then exhale, bring the feet to meet. Roll those shoulders even deeper into the back and then slide that left foot to just over the mat. Holding here, use your breath. Rise that foot to the sky. Take both feet now and hover them over the mat, keeping yourself planted into the mat with that upper body. Breathe in. And then exhale, lift those feet to the sky. Roll those ankles over here, breaking up any lactic acid that may be stuck there. Reverse that direction. And then slowly and gently take both feet, hover them right over the mat. Roll those shoulders deep into your back. Hold. Breathe in. And breathe out. Inhale. And on the exhalation, start to rise those legs to the sky. One more time. Rock those ankles over. Wake up those feet. Rock them opposite direction. And then slowly and gently slide those legs. Last time, all the way down, hovering right over the mat, waking up that core. Take a deep breath in, and a deep breath out. Inhale, and on the exhalation, start to rise those legs all the way up. Fold those legs into the body, knees tight. Wrap your hands around and start to rock here gently, side to side. Nice deep breath in. On the exhalation, cross your ankles over, hold onto the outside edges of your feet, pull those feet into the body, and then pull the knees in towards your chest. Tucking your chin into your chest, see if you can rock yourself all the way up into an easy seated position. We're here today with Taylor and Faith on either sides of the room here, if you hear any snickering in there. And we're practicing our social distancing. Hi, everyone. Let's take our hands to our knees just for a moment. Rolling those shoulders deep into the back here. Taking a deep breath in, roll the shoulders up towards the ears. And then exhale, push them down the back. Inhale, roll those shoulders up towards the ears. And then exhale, push them down the back. One more time, inhale, rolling the shoulders up towards the ears. And then exhale, pushing them down the back. We're gonna inhale, rise those arms up overhead, turning your gaze to those hands. And then exhale, take those hands all the way up in front of you here. Spread those fingers really wide and start to rise yourself up into your tabletop position. Tabletop position, check in that your hands are directly below those shoulders and that your knees are directly below your hips. Drop your tummy down towards the earth, roll the eyes of the apples in towards each other here, and then start to turn your gaze up to the sky as you take a deep breath in. Exhale here, start to arch that spine, bring your navel towards your spine here as you turn your gaze towards that navel. Inhale here for cow pose, gazing up to the sky, open up through that thyroid gland. Exhale, arch that spine, really exaggerate this motion. Inhale here for cow. Exhale for cat. Inhale for cow. And on the exhalation, coming into that neutral tabletop position. Tabletop position, let's tuck those toes under. Roll the eyes of the apples in towards each other and lift those knees off of the mat. Navel pressing to the spine. Take a deep breath in. And then exhale, float those knees down to the mat. Rock here through those shoulders, waking it all up. And then bring yourself to center, roll the eyes of the elbows in towards each other. Toes are still tucked under. Lift those knees off the mat. Take a deep breath in. And then slowly lower those knees to the mat. Take your hips with you now as you rock it here, side to side, cracking it all out. And then when you are ready, bringing yourself back to center, roll the eyes of the abs in towards each other, press evenly through those hands, lift up those knees, bend into those elbows, and push yourself all the way up and back into your very first downward dog of the day. Feel free to pedal those heels here up and down, and lightly and gently shake that head here, yes. And now, breathing in and breathing out. And then when you are ready here, press your heels towards the earth, spread those fingers nice and wide, and then come up high onto those toes, and then sink them to the earth. Come up high onto those toes, and then sink them to the earth. One more time, high onto those toes, and then sinking them towards the earth, roll those shoulders deep into the back, turn your gaze, your drishti towards those knees. Keep them as much of a bend in the knees if you need, or extending the legs more to straighten, bringing the heels towards the earth. Wherever you are at, breathe in. On the exhalation, let's start to float those knees down towards the earth. Flatten your feet onto the mat. Start to sink yourself back and start to take your hands to the sides of your body. Resting here, take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Use your breath throughout your practice, checking in with it as much as you need, making sure that you are flowing with that breath throughout every posture. Breathe in and breathe out. You'll hear me talk a lot about breath in our class today, and that's because so much of our life we take all these shallow, shallow breaths. So I really want to invite you here to breathe, to really get that entire breath into your ribcage throughout your class. Taking one more gorgeous breath, just like this. And then when you are ready, start to slide those arms up overhead, press into those palms, rise yourself up into your tabletop position. Tabletop position, roll those shoulders deeper into the back, tuck your toes under, bring it all the way up, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, pressing evenly into those palms. Let's lift that right foot to the sky. Keep those legs and hips square to the mat below you here. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out here. Inhale. On the exhalation, place that foot down on the mat and pedal your heels up and down. Nice and gentle, take that opposite foot to the sky. Keep those hips square, breathe in. And breathe out here, loosen through that jaw, inhale. On the exhalation, place that foot down on the mat, pedal your heels up and down. Nice and gentle, take those knees nice and wide. Sink yourself back, arms reaching up overhead here if you like. Lower yourself into that child's pose and pause there for a moment. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Inhale. And on the exhalation, pressing into those palms. If the arms are beside the body, let's lift them up overhead. Nice and gentle, ripple yourself forward, pressing into them. Tuck those toes, rise yourself up. Downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, pressing your weight evenly into that right hand. Float that left hand to the outside of your right ankle, calf muscle, or thigh. Knowing that your ankle is the most challenging, select whichever variation works best for you as we gaze underneath that shoulder, opening up here. Breathe in. And breathe out. Inhale. On the exhalation, float that left hand to the mat. Plant evenly down through it as you float your right hand now to your opposite ankle, calf muscle, or thigh, turning your gaze underneath the opposite armpit. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out here, opening up that whole side body. Inhale. On the exhalation, float yourself back to center. Take those knees nice and wide and sink yourself all the way back here into your child's pose. Arms can be up overhead or hands can come to the side of the body, whichever you prefer. Breathe in. And on the exhalation, start to ripple yourself up. Tabletop position, tuck toes, rise it all the way up. Downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, ripple yourself forward into a plank position. Roll the eyes of the elbows in towards each other. Hold here, take a deep breath in. Exhale, hinge into those elbows. Push yourself up. Take yourself all the way back into that downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, ripple yourself forward, plank position. Plank position, option of course to drop to the knees. Let's take ourselves to just over the mat. Holding here, take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Push yourself all the way up and take it all the way back into that downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, take a deep breath in. Exhale, roll yourself forward, plank position, lower all the way down to the mat. Stand with your toes together, roll those shoulders deep into the back. Inhale, come on up, baby cobra. Exhale, head comes down to the mat. Inhale, come on up, baby cobra. Exhale, head comes down to the mat. Inhale, come on up, baby cobra. Exhale, tuck those toes, push yourself up. Take it all the way back into that downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, look up to those hands at the top of the mat. Walk or hop those feet to the top of the mat. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to the knees. Inhale, fly those arms up overhead. Exhale, fold all the way forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands coming to the mat, bend into those knees, hop or walk those feet all the way back into a plank position. Plank position, lower it down through a chaturanga. Inhale through an up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, look up to those hands at the top of the mat, hop or walk those feet through. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to the knees. Inhale, fly those arms up overhead. Exhale, float all the way forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come to the mat, bend into those knees, hop or walk those feet all the way back. Plank position, lower it down through your chaturanga. Inhale through an up dog or a cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, look up to those hands at the top of the mat. Hop or walk those feet all the way through. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to the knees. Inhale, fly those arms up overhead. Exhale, float all the way forward. Last set, inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come to the mat, bend into those knees. Hop or walk those feet all the way back, plank position. Lower it down through your chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog. You have 5 beautiful resting breaths here. water, please do. Honor that. Breathe through it. Inhale. And exhale here, wherever you are at, check in with that jaw. Loosening through the jaw. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Inhale. And on the exhalation, if you are not in downward dog, let's meet up in downward dog. Downward dog, let's nice and gentle ripple ourselves forward, plank position. Roll the eyes of the elbows in towards each other. Second set of these, take a deep breath in. Exhale, hinge into those elbows. Push yourself up. Take it all the way back, downward dog. Downward dog, roll yourself forward, plank position. Take yourself to just over the mat, hold. Take a deep breath in. And then exhale, push it all the way up. Take yourself all the way back, downward dog. Downward dog, ripple yourself forward, plank position, lower it down through that chaturanga, inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, let's lift that right foot to the sky. Keep those hips square to the mat below you here. Take a deep breath in. And then exhale, look up towards those hands at the top of the mat and hop that foot through. Nice job. Nice and gentle here, we're gonna hop that back foot out and pivot it down to the earth. So your feet are on two parallel tracks here. And then start to bend into that front knee as you square your hips to the top of the room, protecting that knee. Let's rise ourselves all the way up, warrior one. Warrior one, nice deep breath in. And deep breath out, check in that knee is not going over the toe, and if it is, just walk that back foot back a little tiny bit, squaring those hips, bending into that front knee. Make sure too that the knee isn't splaying either side. Nice deep breath in, and deep breath out. Inhale, and exhale here, firing to that back leg. Nice deep breath in, and the exhalation, start to slide those hands. Frame that front foot and pivot that back toe. We're gonna take that front foot to the sky, coming into three-legged dog. Now, three-legged dog, you have an option here of taking that foot to the earth, or you're gonna ripple yourself forward into a plank position. Lower it down through your chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, opposite foot is gonna lift to the sky. Keep those hips square to the mat below you here. Look up to that hand and slide that foot through. Nice deep breath in. Hop that back foot out. Pivot it to the earth. Bend into that front knee. Rise yourself all the way up. Warrior one. Warrior one again, checking in that your hips are square to the mat in front of you, that you're bending into that front knee, and that you're nice and firm evenly through that back foot as well. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out. Roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Inhale. And on the exhalation, slide those hands down. Frame your front foot. Pivot that back toe, take that front foot to the sky, three-legged dog. Three-legged dog, of course, option to take that foot down to the earth or ripple yourself forward, plank position. Lower it down through that chaturanga. Inhale into up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog, take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Inhale. And exhale, roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Loosen through that jaw. One more breath, just like this. And then looking up to those hands at the top of the mat, let's hop or walk those feet all the way through. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to the knees. Inhale, fly those arms up overhead. Exhale, start to slide your hands to your heart center and roll those shoulders deep into your back. Rocking your weight into your toes. Toes can be touching or feet can be hips. Apart, whichever you prefer. Nice and gentle, start to rise up. Tuck that tailbone under, navel pressing to the spine, start to slide down that imaginary wall behind you here, keeping yourself though hovered over those calf muscles. Take a deep breath in, and a deep breath out. Inhale, and exhale here, fire through those thighs, use your breath, deep breath in. And then exhale, rise with control. Ooh, let's take those heels to the mat. Inhale, rise the arms up overhead. Exhale, fly all the way forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come to the mat, bend into those knees, hop or walk those feet
All the way back, plank position, lower it down for that chaturanga. Inhale through an up dog or cobra. Exhale,
downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, right foot lifts to the sky. And then look up to those hands as you step that foot through. Hop that back foot out, pivot it to the earth, bend into that front knee, rise yourself all the way up. Warrior one. Warrior one, rolling those shoulders deep into the back. Start to fly those arms to the sides of your body here and start to lean your weight forward. Start to pivot onto that back toe, keeping those hips square to the mat in front of you. Option to stay right here. Or you can start to see if you can lift that back leg and slide yourself into air, plane pose. Nice deep breaths in and deep breaths out here. Flexing that back foot, spread those yogi toes, inhale. And exhale here, use your breath. Firing through that front leg. This is the strongest in our standing poses for our core. Breathe in and breathe out. Use that breath. Your leg should be on fire. Inhale. And on the exhalation, bend into that front knee. Gently land that back foot. Fly those arms to the sky. Warrior one. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out. Let's fly those hands to frame that front foot. Pivot that back toe. Fly that front foot to the sky. Three-legged dog. Three-legged dog. Option to take the foot to the earth or ripple yourself forward. Plank position. Lower it down through your chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Opposite foot lifts to the sky. Look up to those hands. Step that foot through. Hop that back foot out, pivot it to the earth, bend into that front knee, rise it up. Warrior one. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out, hinging into that front knee, inhale. And then exhale, slide those hands to the sides of the body, roll the shoulders deep into the back and hinge here forward. Option to stay like this, or pivot that back toe. Rock yourself more forward and start to lift up. And slide into that warrior three variation of airplane pose. Keep those hips square. Breathe in. And breathe out. Roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Loosen through that jaw. Inhale. And exhale here. Smiles on our faces. This is just yoga. Breathe in. And breathe out here. One more gorgeous breath. Hinge into that front knee. Plant that back foot down. Rise yourself up. Warrior one. Nice deep breath in. And then exhale, frame that front foot. Pivot that back toe. Float that front foot to the sky. Three-legged dog. Three-legged dog. Ripple yourself forward. Plank position. Lower it down through that chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out, grab water if you need it, inhale. And exhale, connect with that breath. One more beautiful breath, just like this. And then looking up to those hands at the top of the mat, let's hop or walk those feet all the way through. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to the knees. Inhale, fly those arms up overhead. Exhale, slide your hands to your heart center, roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Come on up onto those toes here, and then gently start to slide yourself down. Got an imaginary wall behind you here, hovering over those calf muscles. Take a deep breath in, and a deep breath out. Inhale, and exhale here, hold. One more breath. Rise with control. Heels come to the mat. Inhale as hands up overhead. Exhale, float all the way forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come to the mat. Bend into those knees. Hop or walk those feet all the way back. Plank position. Lower it down through that chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. On a deep breath out, let's lift that right foot to the sky. Right foot lifting to the sky, let's look up to those hands, step that foot through. Hop that back foot out, plant it down to the earth.
bent into that front knee. Rise yourself up.
Warrior one. Warrior one, slide those hands behind the back into a clasp position. Lift up with that chin and chest and plant those hands down towards the earth. Bend still into that front knee. Take a deep breath in as we open up here through our thyroid gland, revving into our metabolism. Exhale, fold all the way forward. Bring your shoulders to the inside of that front knee as you drop your crown of the head towards the earth. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out here. Inhale and exhale. Lifting those hands as high off the back as possible. Press your palms in towards each other. And then when you are ready, start to drop those hands to the inside of that front foot and pivot that back toe. Now lots of options here. You can stay right here. You can take your knee down to the earth or down to a cushion if that works for you. If you have books here and you'd like to take your forearms to books or to the earth, you can. Just be sure if you are in lizard lunge, you're pushing the knee in towards the shoulder to really protect your knee here. Nice deep breaths in and deep breaths out wherever you are at. If you are coming into the arm balancing pose, you are starting off on your hands. From here, you are rocking that right shoulder underneath your right knee. And then you're walking your opposite hand back so that you're in line with each other. You are tugging that back toe if the back leg is on the ground, lifting that foot up. And then slowly and gently lifting that front foot, lift that back leg, lift all the way up. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Inhale and exhale here. Wherever you are at is awesome. Breathe in and breathe out. One more breath. And then slowly and gently, if you are in the arm balancing pose, release. Those of us in lizard lunge, if you are on the forearms, nice and gentle, start to rise up to those hands. If you have the back leg lifted, you can lower it to the earth. And then nice and gentle, take that right hand, take your foot, start to sickle it out to the side, and right hand comes to the inside of that right knee, and you're gonna rotate your upper body towards the side of the room. Opening up here. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. You can stay right here, or if it is in your practice to start to bend that back foot into the body, you can. If you wanna catch that back foot and open up even further here, you can, just an option. Breathing in, breathing out. Inhale, and exhale here. Starting to pull the foot closer into the body. If you have the foot caught, really get into that stretch. And then slowly and gently release that back leg if you had it caught. Nice and gentle, start to bring that foot back to the earth here. Hands coming to the mat, tuck that back toe, lift that back knee, shoot that front foot back, plank position. Plank position, lower it down through your chaturanga. Inhale into an up dog or cobra. Exhale. Downward facing dog, take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. I'm getting a little clock here because I'm getting sweating. Breathing in and breathing out. Inhale. On the exhalation, let's lift that opposite foot. Left foot lifts to the sky. Looking up to those hands, step that foot through. Hop that back foot out, plant it down to the earth, bend into that front knee, rise yourself all the way up in warrior one position. Warrior one position, sweep those hands down your back. Nice and gentle, pressing the palms in towards each other here. Lift the chin and chest to the sky. And then nice and gentle, start to fold all the way forward, bringing your shoulder to the inside of that front knee, dropping the crown of the head towards the earth. The breath is even in and out through the nose. Weight is evenly distributed between those feet. Breathe in and breathe out. Lift those arms as high off the back as possible. Press the palms towards each other. Inhale. And on the exhalation, take those hands to the inside of that front foot and pivot that back toe here. Now lots of options. You can stay here, or you can lower that back knee to the earth, flattening that foot. You can take your arms to those blocks if you have them, or to the earth if you like. Wherever you are at, the breath is even in and out through the nose, and you are pushing that knee in towards the shoulder. Nice deep breath in. If you are coming into that arm balancing pose here, you are starting off on your hands.
Nice and down off the knees, down. You are tucking that back toe, lifting that leg up. You are dropping that left shoulder underneath that left knee. You are walking the right hand back so that they're in line with each other. You're rocking your weight forward, lifting that top leg. Lift that back leg up. Nice deep breaths in and deep breaths out wherever you are at. Inhale and exhale here. Nice job, ladies. Inhale and gentlemen. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. We've got one more breath wherever you are at. And then nice and slow, if you're in the arm balancing pose, release out. Everyone leaning back up in that beautiful lizard lunge. Take that back knee to the earth if you had it lifted and flatten that foot. And then nice and gentle, take your left hand to the inside of that left knee as you sickle out onto the outside edge of that left foot. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out, rotating your hips and shoulders towards that knee. Inhale and exhale here. If you want more of a stretch, see if you can start to bring that foot into the body. See if you can reach back and catch that foot and hold. At first, keeping the foot away from you here as you really stretch more into the shoulder. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. Inhale. On the exhalation, start to pull the foot tighter into the body, really now getting into that thigh. Breathe in and breathe out. Opening up here, inhale. And on the exhalation, gently start to float that foot to the earth. Start to rock yourself back to center. You're pressing evenly through those palms. Tuck that back toe. Shoot yourself back into that plank position and hold. Roll those shoulders deep into the back. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Inhale. On the exhalation, start to lower your knees to the earth and start to sandwich your toes together. And start to roll yourself back into a puppy dog pose variation here as you roll those shoulders deeper into the back. Pause here, breathe in and breathe out here. Our next posture that we're gonna be setting up for is peacock pose. So it has lots and lots and lots of steps. It's actually one I'm pretty terrible at. So it's gonna be fun to really play with it today and see what we can do with it. It is an amazing posture for really strengthening your wrists, strengthening your forearms, and really getting your body used to balance. How to do balance distributions, which will really help you later if you're going into those headstands, handstands, all of that. To really train your body to find that peace in between. So what we're going to do, from puppy dog position, we're gonna rise ourselves up. We're gonna nice and gentle start to take our hands and fold them in towards our body. Fingertips towards your body. You're gonna start to bend into those elbows, and this may be enough for you. If you're here and you're like, you know, this is good, you can stay right here. Otherwise, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start to rotate our weight forward here, nice and gentle. We're gonna start to take ourselves into a plank-like position and start to land our hips right on where our elbows are. So basically, your hips are crossing right in. They're crossing right in into your hip bones here. Nice and gentle here, elbows towards those hips. You're gonna start to float yourself forward and catch there. Once you've caught there, you're gonna start to tuck those toes under. And then nice and gentle, I always like to start off here with my chin on the mat. Now you don't have to do that. If you're able to get up all the way without that, that's how I like to start. And then from here, you're gonna start seeking and lift up one foot and perhaps the other. And then start to lift those feet as high up as you can. From here, now this is the tricky part. You need to lift that chin and hold. And that's where I'm terrible at it. But if you can find that balance, that teeter-totter, you will be amazing rock star. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. Wherever you are at, playing in this peacock pose, really working with the core here. If it seems impossible at first, just remember step by step by step. I'm gonna walk you through it one more time. So, taking the knees together, toes are touching, folding the hands into the body here, making sure that when you land, you're landing the elbows right into the creases of your hips. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out, really catching there. And then nice and gentle, tucking those toes, lifting yourself up. I always start with my chin on the mat. Start to lift one foot up, perhaps the other foot comes up. Lifting those legs as high up as you can. And then slowly, if you get it, you can start to lift that chin. It's almost impossible, but one day we'll all get there. And then slowly and is you're gonna roll onto that right side and lift that left arm up and take it behind you. Open up here. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. Beautiful work. Take that hand to the earth. Opposite arm floats all the way up. Open up. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. Take that hand to the earth. Rock yourself forward here. Just roll those wrists over a couple times after all that awesomeness on them. And then we're going to come into one more standing posture before we take ourselves down for our psoas sets. Tuck your toes under, rise yourself up into your downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, look up to those hands and start to walk your feet forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, head comes to knees. Inhale, rise the arms up overhead. Exhale, start to float your hands to your heart center and roll those shoulders deep into your back. Now I'm gonna mirror you, I'm gonna do opposite here. So I hope Instagram that works. I think that they don't mirror it.
They don't.
Anyway, we're gonna start off here with our right foot. I'm gonna do my left, sorry Instagram people. Nice and gentle here, rocking your weight down. Let's lift that right foot up. And then you're just gonna cross that foot right over. Good work. Now, if it is in your practice to take that foot and fold it into full lotus, you can, but this might be a little bit challenging. So if you're finding that there's no way that this is gonna happen, keep your foot lower, that's totally fine. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna start to, let me see if I can hold the side here, start to sink your weight back here. And then start to flex that foot if you do not have it in full lotus. If you are in full lotus all the way up here, don't flex the foot, you don't need to. Rocking your weight forward here. Now you can stay right here in this stretch, or if you want to take it into that on mountain pose, you are dropping the fingertips to the back. And then exactly the same way as you come into crow, you're going to hook the foot over that shoulder. You're going to rock your weight forward. And then nice and gentle, what we've been working for there in pigeon and all of our other poses, you're just going to lift yourself up here. This helps with our peacock as well. Nice deep breath in and deep breath out. Start to pull the knee into the body, land that foot to the earth, and then nice and gentle rise all the way up. Use that core strength, oh my. Nice and gentle, plant both feet to the mat. And pedal down, out. If there was no way that that was even gonna happen, just stay in that first variation. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out. We're gonna do opposite side now, and I'll go the opposite direction so we can see. Nice and gentle. Let's start to fold that foot into the body, flexing the foot if you're keeping it lower, taking the foot into the groin if you're coming into that lotus pose. Nice deep breath in. Exhale, start to fold it forward and stick that bum out so you really get into that stretch. Staying right here. Or floating those hands down towards the earth. Staying right here. You're really getting into a good stretch right here too. Otherwise, you're rocking your weight forward. You're hooking those toes under where your armpit is. And then slowly and gently, just like that, you're lifting up that back leg. Woohoo! Nice deep breaths in and deep breaths out. Wherever you are at is awesome. Inhale. And exhale here, one more breath. If you are in the arm balancing pose, pull the foot into the body. Land that foot down. And then super tricky part, so you can rise yourself all the way up. Ooh, shake it. Put that foot down on the earth and shake it out. Nice work. Let's inhale, rise those arms up overhead. Exhale here, take a little mini micro back bend. And then gently fold all the way forward. Inhale here, halfway lift. Exhale, hands come to the mat, hop or walk those feet all the way back, plank position. Lower it down to back chaturanga. Inhale, left dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, take those knees wide. Sink yourself back here into a child's pose. Walk those hands all the way over to the right. Opening up that whole side body here, bring your head as close down to your knees as possible, really opening up through that whole shoulder girdle and that whole side body here, those side obliques. And then gently walking yourself back to center. And then slowly walking yourself over the opposite direction. feeling that pull here. If you do not feel this pull from the shoulder girdle to your side body, you need to walk those hands even further over to the side. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out here. Inhale. And we're excellent, starting to walk those hands back to center. From center, ripple yourself up. Tuck your feet across each other. And slide yourself all the way back. Nice and gentle here, bumping your bum a little bit more forward. Start to roll those shoulders deep into the back here and start to find that C curve. Once you've found that C curve, start to lift those feet up, cross your ankles over, and keep your ankles tight to your bum here at first as you rock those arms to the sides of the body. And we're gonna hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And we're gonna cross opposite direction, lift up with that chin and chest, and hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And on opposite direction, hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And on opposite direction, hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And when bringing into that bow pose, heels are high, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And when extend those legs all the way up, straight core engaged, roll those shoulders down into the back, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And when lift it up, heels high, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And when shift those legs forward, hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And when lift it up, bow pose, heels are high, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And give yourself a hug and rock it side to side. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Inhale. And with the exhalation, cross those ankles over. No big breaks. Arms coming to the sides of the body. We are holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, cross opposite direction. And when you are doing that, make sure the heels remain tight to the body. We are holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, cross opposite direction. Hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, cross opposite direction. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, bring it up. Knees are high, heels are high. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, extend that right leg out. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, bring it to center. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And I want to extend that leg out, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And I want to bring it to center, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And I want to take those knees into the body and then extend them all the way out. Take the knees into the body and extend it all the way out. Take the knees into the body, extend it all the way out. Hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, bring it up, bow pose, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, give yourself a hug and rock it side to side. Good job, this foam is doing something funny, so hold on. Yay! All right, everybody, no big breaks. We have one more set of those. Okay, let's cross our ankles over. Lift our chin and chest to the sky. We are holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one opposite direction, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one opposite direction, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one opposite direction, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one more time, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, bring it up, bow pose, hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, extend those legs up. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, like a pendulum, take them down to just over the mat. We only got one set of these. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, lift it up. Bow pose. Hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. And one, give yourself And a deep breath out. Let's plant those feet down onto the mat. Fingertips come towards the back of the room. Roll those shoulders into the back and start to windshield wiper those legs side to side. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out. And then nice and gentle here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna roll those shoulders deeper in the back, walk those hands a little closer into the body, walk the feet a little bit closer into the body, feet are hips distance apart. Roll those shoulders deep into the back and start to lift that tummy to the sky and start to drop that head all the way back. Firing here through that core, breathe in and breathe out. Inhale. And on the exhalation, start to lower yourself all the way down. Nice and gentle, you can come right back up into that exact same variation, reverse table, or you can start to lower your forearms to the earth. Start to tuck your bum closer towards your heels and start to lower down all the way onto your back. Taking your fingertips to the sky, fold the hands in towards your face. Nice and gentle, keeping those elbows pointing evenly up towards the sky, planting evenly through your feet. Start to lift your hips. And then start to lift yourself onto the crown of the head. Crown of the head, you can lift yourself all the way up, coming into wheel pose. Take a deep breath in, and a deep breath out. Inhale, and exhale here. Nice deep breaths. Coming up onto those toes, if that's in your practice. And then slowly and gently, starting to lower yourself all the way down. As you come down, start to pull on those heels. Nice and gentle here, start to rock those shoulders deep into the back. Breathe in. And then just for fun, start to roll that right shoulder down towards the earth. Start to take the knee down as well and start to rock yourself all the way over. Once on your tummy, start to kick back and lift all the way up. Coming up here. Breathing in and breathing out. You can do it. Inhale and exhale. Your kick back. And then press those legs back down into the body. Roll that shoulder underneath you here. Rock all the way back in. And we have two sides. So nice and gentle, start to drop your opposite shoulder to the earth. Start to roll the opposite way, coming onto your tummies. And then nice and gentle here, start to kick back. Lift up. Nice deep breath in. And deep breaths out, tons of fun. Inhale, and exhale, here you go. Sorry guys. Nice deep breath in, deep breath out. And then nice and gentle, land those legs to the end. Roll yourself back over, amazing job. Start to hug the knees into the body. And circle the knees in a little circle around to the right. Pause there. Let's go the opposite direction with those legs. And then nice and gentle, planting those feet down, roll the shoulders deep into the back. Take your arms out into a letter T position, roll the shoulders even deeper into the back, tuck the chin into the chest. Take those legs to the sky here. Now option, you can eagle those legs if that is in your practice, wrapping them around each other. Only an option. If you prefer to keep yourself just like this, please honor that. And then slowly and gently start to rotate those knees over to the right. And slowly turn your head the opposite direction of those legs. Roll the shoulders deeper into the back here. Breathe in. And breathe out. Loosen through that jaw. Inhale. And exhale here. Connecting the shoulders still into the earth though. Loosen. Breathe. Releasing that lower lumbar spine. And then when you are ready, nice and gentle here. Let's start to rise those legs to center. If you have the legs tucked around each other, unravel those legs. Ravel in the opposite direction. And then slowly take those knees the opposite way and turn your head the opposite way. Do your best to keep both shoulders on the earth here as you twist. Beautiful posture here, releasing that spine. Nice deep breath in. And deep breath out. Inhale. And exhale here. Connecting the breath all the way through the body. One more beautiful breath, just like this. And then when you are ready, slowly and gently here, start to roll yourself back to center. Rolling back to center, unravel yourself.
And then nice and gentle, start to lower those feet to the mat. Nice and gentle, start to rock those legs side to side. And then when you are ready, start to pull the knees into the body here. Nice and gentle, start to gather those knees in really tight and bring your forehead right up to those knees. Roll those shoulders even deeper into the back. Take a deep breath in. Give yourself a giant squeeze, squeeze with all your might. And then when you're ready, start to lower the shoulders down towards the earth. Tucking the chin into the chest, fold the hands out to the sides of the body. Extend those legs up to the sky, roll through those ankles a couple more times. Releasing out any lactic acid in those legs. Relieving any sort of stress in the legs. Flex the heels to the sky, toes towards your face. Take a deep breath in. And then nice and gentle, roll the knees in towards your chest. And start to extend that left leg all the way down to the edge of your mat. Right leg extends, take it down to the edge of the mat. Tuck the chin into the chest and fold the arms to the sides of your body. Taking a deep breath in through the nose. Let's exhale it here twice as long through the mouth. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And exhale twice as long through the mouth. One more of those gorgeous cleansing breaths. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And exhale twice as long through the mouth. And then when you are ready, start to close that mouth. Releasing any tension that may be stuck in between your eyebrows, in your eyelids, and in your jaw as you gently float those eyes to close. Start to release your tongue off of the roof of the mouth, interrupting conscious thought. Let yourself melt. Let yourself be.